Hey guys, it's Sarah from Just My Typewriter, here again with some free, in quotations, typewriter apps for your mobile device. Free because I'm cheap, and typewriter-based because, well, I'm crazy. So the first thing I did was just type typewriter into the search bar. There's a wide array of apps labeled as typewriter within the Apple App Store. They can vary from being font-based apps, to providing the user with a library of fonts, photo and editing apps to make it look like text is being typed on a screen by a typewriter, and then some apps that just use typewriter in the name to evoke writerly vibes. Of the apps I looked at, I picked 6 to really test out my own device. Each app had to either have a typewriter in the name or as the app icon, and then had to also be free for download. Because, once again, I am cheap. The 6 apps I chose to look at were Write Only, Typewriter Artist, Typewriter Genius, Hanks Writer, Typewriter Fonts and Keyboards, and the Magical Typewriter. That's right, magic. The first in the bunch is this app, Write Only. I chose this app because the icon, of course, is a bright red typewriter. According to the description, this app is designed to recreate the writing experience of being with a typewriter, which means also no backspacing or editing as you go. This is intended to help you focus on writing rather than writing and editing. The app also has you save the documents as a PDF, so it's exactly how you typed it, errors, highlighting, ribbon colors included. I really like the concept of this app if you're a writer. There are those in the typewriter community who claim typewriters make you slow down and think about what you're writing because, again, you can't go back. Everything is permanent. By integrating this concept into the app directly, the developers are creating an experience for users who want a more digital experience, or at least something they can save on their computer for later. This design is visually very sparse, which helps limit distractions, but it can also make it a little weird to navigate at first. I didn't even know how to open anything once I got this app. Additionally, I really appreciate how the keyboard is designed within this app so that the top row includes common punctuation, a highlighter, and a ribbon selector. This makes it feel more accessible to just write. The cursor always stays fixed in the middle, again, much like a real typewriter, so you're not watching the text crawl across the page as you write. The reviews are mixed on this one, but overall, I think it achieves an experience in which a person can hopefully separate themselves a little bit from the usually distracting nature of their phone and write. If that's what they want. I don't think I'll be keeping this one on my phone though, I'd rather just stick to my real typewriter. On to something a little less useful. This is Typewriter Artist. Although once downloaded, it's just labeled as Typewriter Genius. With typewriter in the name, I was gonna get this app regardless. But this app also has the added benefit of diving into typewriter art, which I've done briefly on this channel when I showed you how to make typewriter cats in my typewriter earrings video. This app actually has 0 ratings and no stars. It's easy to see why once you open the app. Without reading the instructions, I attempted to use this app to make acai, acici, asa whatchamacallit art, and I had no idea how to start. Basically, you hold your finger down on the screen, anywhere on the screen as it appears, and hold it until the cursor hits the red line. If you make it all the way to the red line, you get a positive affirmation, like good. The cursor then jumps down to the next line until you create an image, gathering stars as you go to trade in for stickers and such. You can also watch ads within the app for additional stars. There's no visible keyboard in this app, but there are typewriter-esque sounds, and some of the images do give me ideas of things to try on my actual typewriter. Maybe. Someday. If I feel creative enough, then maybe. I was a little annoyed that the quote-unquote game only asked me to place my finger on the screen. It wasn't very active, but the design and feel was kind of adorable. 10 out of 10 wouldn't download again, but the fact that it exists is kind of cool. I might even decide to leave a quick review. So another app labeled as Typewriter Genius, made by the same people, only 1 rating of 1 star. It's labeled as the most peaceful typewriter game, and it's the exact same concept as the Typewriter Artist app. Hold on the screen until you hit the red line. The design is visually different within the app, using a more realistic typewriter photo over the illustration. However, the quotes as you type are rather unrelatable and frankly a little weird, like, not my New Year's resolution, dieting. After you've typed the message, you can customize the font and the paper type. Then it's saved in the app and available for you to add to your photo wall, a fake display of empty frames for you to fill with your very odd typed quotes. This app to me is even less fun than the typewriter art app because the final pieces are just kind of vague. And at least in the art app, I can use those pieces as templates if I want to transfer them to my own typewriters later. Neither app really does it for me, and Typewriter Genius has a ton of ads that pop up that can be really obnoxious, but I guess that's what you get when you're cheap like me. An old familiar for you. This is the Hanks Writer app. We've played with this one before in my Digital Typewriters video, which you can watch at the link in the description. As an app, Hanks Writer allows you to type on a keyboard that is reminiscent of a typewriter keyboard. You can enable features like keystroke sounds, no editing forcing you to X over your mistakes, and also use the free version of the app as a keyboard in other applications. You'll have to navigate to your settings, go to General, Keyboards, and then add a new keyboard and select the app you'd like to enable to use in other apps. This way you can use your keyboard in everything. Once in an app, click and hold the little planet in the corner to change the keyboards. And once you're done with the app, or you would like to delete it, simply navigate back to the keyboard settings area, select Edit, and Delete. You can turn documents you have in Hanks Writer into PDFs and send them wherever you like as well. There are also more options you can enable if you purchase the full app. The options include more ribbon colors, different keyboard styles, different paper types, and more. As a phone app, it's a nice typewriter feel to have on a daily basis when you pick up your phone. But it's not the only typewriter keyboard app on the market. This is Typewriter Keyboards. This app allows you to customize your very own third-party keyboard, which you can then integrate into your phone. You can customize background color, key shapes, key fonts, key size, key color, and even the language of the keyboard. Once you have it the way you like, just set it as an available keyboard in your keyboard settings and use it in other apps. While Hanks Writer also has a function within the app to type and create documents, this app is a keyboard customizer only. It doesn't look exactly like a typewriter either, but you can add the sounds if you like. It's really important to remember that using third-party keyboard plugins allows those app developers to have access to all of the information you've typed using that keyboard. So if you set your keyboard to Typewriter Keyboard, they now have access to everything you type, including sensitive information like bank pins, messages, or social security numbers. The Hanks Writer app does allow you to switch on and off access functions, which means it can limit the amount of data they record while you're typing, but this typewriter app does not have that function. That's important to keep in mind when utilizing this app. Of the two, I much prefer Hanks Writer because I feel that it looks more like an actual typewriter keyboard. And I like that you can select the level of information you want the app to have access to. Now here's something different. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to make an avatar busty witch and parade around a castle and be confused by spells and constantly prompted to buy more coins in order to properly solve puzzles presented in the game? Well, then here's the app for you. Based on the app for the icon, I was pretty sure the typewriter was not the main feature of this game, despite the name. But the good news is, I found the magical typewriter in the very first room. I have very little narrative gaming experience. My experience really consists of a ton of Wii Pet Sports and constantly doing all of the Mario Kart tracks backwards, but this game allows you to make your own character and then navigate around this really cool looking castle, solving puzzles and answering the call of quests. To get you started, they drop you into a room with a guestbook and a piano to teach you some of the basic skills to operate the game, and at the center is what I'm assuming is the magical typewriter. I was able to figure out how to enter some of the other rooms, and I did end up collecting some of this orange poison or gunk for spells. But many of the tasks required me to spend a certain amount of coins, which would require me to purchase said coins. That kind of limited me in how much I could accomplish within this first sitting, although I do believe the app has wizard-based tournaments where you can win more coins. But I was having enough trouble just figuring out how to move the game as it was. I think the graphics are actually quite beautiful, and if I was more adventurous and a patient person, I might even actually be able to accomplish something in this game, but I came for the typewriter, and the typewriter did I see. So of the free apps, are there any worth using? I think it depends on what you're looking for. I'm sure if you were into gaming, the magical typewriter could be fun. For typewriter keyboard integration, Hanks Writer is a nice plugin, even in the free version, and it's endorsed by the typewriter godfather. But everything else wasn't really worth the space that it took up on my phone. Both of the Typewriter Genius games were similar in design and were only entertaining for about a minute of play. I could see them being maybe fun for a younger user, but they don't change much as you level up, and they don't really imitate realistic typing experiences. As far as the keyboard app, I much prefer the info selection of the Hanks Writer over the other keyboard app. As always, there's nothing that really replicates the full typing experience like just getting another typewriter. But it's cool that typewriters can exist in a digital age. Thanks so much for watching today. For more typewriter content, check out the other videos on this channel. I have some related videos linked in the description on this video. We also have an Instagram at just.my.typewriter. Thanks so much for watching, and I want to remind you that you're just my type. Writer.